Good afternoon, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, Shabbat Shalom. I hope you are having a blessed and a peaceful Sabbath day. Now, today we're going to talk about who wears the pants. I'll probably step on at least one toe. I'll probably offend at least one feeling. So beforehand, I apologize. It's information. It's the Father's Word. I'm going to put it out there. Well, first, let's find out who the orchestrator of all the chaos is. For those who don't know, and you should all know by now, who orchestrates chaos. 1 Corinthians 14:33 reads like this: "For God is not the author of confusion, but of peace, as in all churches of the saints." So, if the Word says that He is not the orchestrator of confusion, who does that leave? The adversary, the enemy, the devil. That's his thing. All this chaos and confusion in the world is his. All the things that have led up to all the confusion we have in society now is the work of the enemy. And it's been done through people. He didn't walk around and do it. He did it through people. The Word says, for believers, He is peace, the Father. He is peace. Now, for believers who don't subscribe to being a follower of this peace through the way they live their life, and not just by saying, then they're going to feel the weight. You are going to feel the weight of all these worldly consequences on you in your daily life at some point or another, if not all the time. So if that's the case, you need to stop talking about it and start living it in the way you do things to ease these burdens in your daily life. See, believers walk around, oh, I love the Lord and all this stuff all day long, but they're talking and not living it, and then wondering why they have so much chaos, pain, drama, situations, whatever in their lives. That's why, because you're talking it and not living it. So start living it. The Word says in Ephesians 5:22 through 24, this, go with me there, Ephesians 5:22 through 24. Wives, submit yourselves unto your husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and He is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let wives be to their own husbands in everything. Okay, ladies, calm down before you get started. You can get up off the floor, you can close your mouth, and listen, because it gets deeper than that. Because I know that people, men and women alike in society, have taken these scriptures and run with them, and people will ignore them and avoid them like the plague because they don't want to cater to what the Father's Word says. But there's more to it than just these three verses. Now, first remember, I'm talking to those who claim to be believers, those who are living it. Not the ones who are just talking it, but a lot of people are talking it, so these three scriptures make the hair on the back of their neck stand up and get them to hemming and hawing about what they say. So I guess I'm talking to believers who aren't really living it for the most part. Okay, understand this. We're going to go there. Now, why do these verses say this? Well, because this establishes order and prevents confusion and chaos among His people, amongst the Father's people. He needs order and chaos. This is why those scriptures say that. Now, how many of you have chaos and confusion in your home? A lot of you do. How many of you have power struggles and control issues with each other, husband and wife, or even with your children in the midst of all that? Because when the husband and wife are going through all this power struggling and chaos and confusion, if you have kids in your home, it just adds right to it. So there's all this anarchy in the home. So understand, here's the caveat. For you ladies out there, His people has to include your husband. So now you can breathe. See, in order for those scriptures to work, your husband has to be one of His people. He has to be a believer. He has to be doing whatever according to the Father's Word. If not, that chaos ensues, as some of you are living it every minute of every day. Also, husbands and wives, understand that neither of your parents, his nor yours, have any authority in your household. Remember, I'm talking to believers, not you worldly folks out there, or those ones who claim to be that can't get by things like this. You have to be a believer doing what the Father's Word says. Go with me to Genesis 2:24. It reads, it says, "Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh." That means a man or a woman, they shall leave their parents and cleave unto each other and become one flesh. Keep your parents out of your business. They have no authority. See, the only thing you can gain from that is biased counsel, biased advice, biased whatever. And that's never going to help when you're dealing with those kinds of situations. It's very risky, people, to drag your parents into whatever's going on in your home. Very risky. Now, for a believing wife to submit to her husband as the head of the home, the husband must understand his responsibility. Now, I know you ladies like to hear that, so tell your husband, he must understand his responsibility, especially if he is not doing right by you and the rest of his family. Cheating, being irresponsible financially or whatever, being a tyrant, abusive, disrespectful, etc. But yet, he claims to love the Father. Isn't that a lot of irony? I know a lot of you have husbands like that. Lord this, Lord that, I love the Lord this. And then as soon as they turn around to you and the family, they're tyrants, they're mean, they're abusive, they're cheaters and all that. See, you know that. We don't outside of that. So the facade that people put on outside their home works for them. But you know the truth, and that only adds to your pain and woe within your own household. Go with me to Ephesians 5:25, and it reads like this. Husbands, love your wives. See, now we're just telling wives to submit to their husbands. Husbands, this is what you have to do so that they don't have a problem doing what they're supposed to do. Husbands, love your wives even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. Husbands, are you willing to give yourself for your wife? If you love your wife, you should be willing to do that if necessary. Verse 26, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourished and cherished it, even as the Lord the church. So, simply put, men, if you love yourself, love your wife. You don't hate yourself, so why should you hate your wife? Treat her as you treat yourself. If you love yourself, treat your wife, children, household accordingly. See, it works in unison. People want to hang on to scriptures that says, wife, submit to your husband. But husbands, I'm telling you, you have just a greater responsibility. See, because we are to submit to the church. We are to submit to the Father. Everybody has to submit to one another. In other words, husbands, love your wives and be not bitter against them. Colossians 3:19. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. Ephesians 4:31. And be ye kind to one another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. Ephesians 4:32. As for the wives and the husband, see, this all works together. A home filled with rebellion in it cannot conform to doing what is mandated by the Father's word. If peace and love are in it, then it's working. But some of you know there's no peace and love in your home because you're living in these horrible situations, because that's how you feel and that's how you view them. Look, neither wives, nor the husbands, nor children submit to anything except the enemy. Now, if the husband, ladies, listen, if the husband fails to fulfill his duties, this does not justify the wife in failing to fulfill hers, or vice versa. Husbands, if your wife fails to fulfill her duties, this does not justify you not fulfilling yours. See, the father's got it covered. There's no excuse for going out here cheating or doing this, that, and the other because, well, she ain't doing what she's supposed to do. He ain't doing what he's supposed to do. The father says there's no justification. Remember, husbands, you don't answer to your wives, and wives, you don't answer to your husbands. You first answer to the father. That's who you answer to. See, if everybody gets those priorities straight, then they'll do right by each other in terms of understanding. If you don't do what you're supposed to do and use the other person as justification, you're at risk of going into rebellion against the father. You're not in a rebellion against your husband, and husbands, you're not in rebellion against your wife or children, vice versa, whatever. You are in rebellion against the Heavenly Father. Romans 12, 17 through 21 read like this. Recompense to no man evil for evil. Provide things honest in the sight of all men. If it be possible, as much as lieth in you, live peaceably with all men. Dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves, but rather give place unto wrath. For it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord. Therefore, if thine enemy hunger, feed him. If he thirst, give him drink. For in so doing that, thou shalt heap coals of fire on his head. Be not overcome of evil, but overcome evil with good. Look, these scriptures, these verses right here say, don't repay evil with evil. No tit for tat. See, people are good at that tit for tat. He did it to me, I'm going to do it to him. She did it to me, I'm going to do it to her. The father says, don't do that. Why? He says, vengeance is his. He's going to repay. He's going to make all those payments out to who deserved them. He's going to pay that evil for the evil that they committed. See, that's not your job. See, the father wants you to be peaceful. He wants you to be humble. He wants you to be meek, all these things. If you're busy paying back somebody, there's nothing meek and humble and loving in that. Save yourself the trouble. Let the Father do his work. You do what you're supposed to do. He says also that we are to live at peace with all men. But you know, the most intriguing thing is, he says, if your enemy hungers, feed him. If he thirsts, give him drink. He says, in doing so, we heap coals of fire on their head. Kill them with kindness. See, kindness brings pain to mean people because it creates chaos in them. They can't understand why you're doing what you do, why you're doing what you do as they are mean to you. Your father says you're heaping coals of fire on them. That's how you overcome evil. Overcome evil with good. And then on top of that, he's going to take care of business when he deems fit. So mind your P's and Q's. Let the Father do his work, as always. Now, with that being said, don't get caught up and let your home situation cause you to become part of the Father's vengeance. Do right. Do what's right and trust that he will see you through whatever this trial is, whatever this mess is going on in your home. Look, read Luke 6, 27 to 35. I'm not going to read it now, but it tells you about your enemies. It tells you some things that you should and shouldn't do. Read it. Luke 6, 27 through 35. A few minutes. It's not going to kill you, and it may help you. Now, also keep in mind with all that, if your husband is doing right by the Father, you are covered because he understands who he has to answer to. See, I know who I answer to. I don't answer to my wife. I answer to the Father. That in turn causes me to do right by her. See, we have to have our priorities straight. Her the same. She answers to the Father first, and she realizes that. So that causes her to treat me accordingly. We have to quit looking at each other with these worldly eyes that causes us all kinds of problems. We get our priorities screwed up and everything else. We can't do that. So therefore, Colossians 3, 18 and 20 shouldn't be a problem. And they read like this. 18 reads, wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as it is fit in the Lord. 20, children, obey your parents in all things, for this is well-pleasing unto the Lord. This is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.